Hi, I'm Dr. Johnny. Thanks for joining me today. The controversy this month, if you can believe it, online, Instagram, social media, is lip filler and lip filler distortion, lip filler migration. We're going to touch on that. We know fillers can migrate. Particularly, the discussion is lip fillers, and understand a lot of people's livelihoods, yes, are all about the lip filler. People make their living off of lip filler. We're going to touch on that, but I'm pointedly going to answer the cause of why this is a big issue. A lot of people are saying it's technique. We'll talk about that. Is it the type of filler? Well, that companies are tied to this because that could certainly hurt them. People are coming out and saying, yes, it's certain fillers and not other fillers. Is it the patient? Is it you? And is it just because of the anatomy or some other reason? It could be just bad luck. It could be the injector. Heaven forbid, could be the injector. We're going to answer that too. Is it something else? And I want you to stay tuned to the end for this something else part, because it's really important. I need you in this video because I really want your opinion. And this transcends somewhat life. We'll get to that. Very interesting. But I do need you to stay to the end so you can help me decipher that. It definitely is controversial. You know I often stay away from controversial topics. We're diving in today because I think it's that important. And it's not just applicable to lip fillers, but all fillers and really what we're doing in aesthetic medicine. I know people have heated views on this. Remember, I'm here to sort through it all to help you get the best treatments for the best cost and pointedly so you get your results safely and effectively. And that's why the channel's here for education purposes. So if you like that, subscribe, like. The only way we grow is you smash that like button so it helps us with our YouTube algorithm and I can bring more of these videos. Let's dive straight into the controversy. So first up is technique. And I'd say this is where most of the controversy lies, because absolutely technique can be to blame. So it could be part of the technique. Now people attach their names to techniques, their countries to techniques. So they feel very passionate about it. And of course, lip fillers are driver to practice. So there's financial motivation for people to teach certain things and say it's the best. And that's what creates part of that, okay? Lip fillers have been around for, I don't know, plus 30 years, because 25 years ago I did it with collagen, okay, before the hyaluronic acids were introduced in America. Of course, they had them in Europe earlier in other countries, but before that it was collagen. So this procedure's been done forever in every variation, yes, that you see today. I know the telephone was dial-up at that time. I get it that people believe a lot of this is new, but the reality is the ones you're going to hear about, Russian, I'm hesitating because I was going to say tenting, but you don't want to offend the Russians, because if you lump those anywhere close to each other, if there's a bit of overlap, you're going to offend people. So you'll hear the Russian, you'll hear, let's call it the tenting technique, and then the traditional technique where we're filling, let's call it the tubercles of the lip. That's simplifying the anatomy. But when you talk about anatomy, understand there's muscle, variability of vasculature, which comes into the controversy, because sometimes the vessel is behind the muscle of the lip, sometimes it's in the muscle, sometimes it's a little more anterior to the front. But of course people bring in safety, and understanding that people are passionately tied to certain lip filler names, there is financial motivation for people to teach and train, because it's a big driver to practices. And when people say that technique isn't safe, people get inflamed. It's like a bad pimple. It does pop at some point, and it will, but the reality is there's a happy medium to this. I want to say technique does play a role, absolutely. What about the type of filler? The type of filler absolutely plays a role, because some of it draws water. And in the beauty of collagen back in the day, yes, we would put hyaluronic acid in the body of the lip, but then in the border, which is where a lot of this controversy comes from, we would put collagen. That's what the rich did, because collagen doesn't draw water in. It didn't migrate. It integrated very well with the tissues. And that's another part of the filler. Does it draw water in? Does it integrate? And if so, when? That brings Issue number three, is it the patient's fault? Are they massaging it? Is it migrating because the patient has an issue and their anatomy maybe is a little bit different? And the answer simply is no. It isn't the patient's fault. Certainly there are anatomical variations, but much more commonly would be the fourth issue, which is too much filler. If you stuff a closed space, especially with one of those fillers that draws water in, that doesn't integrate that well, then certainly you're going to have migration of that filler. It has to go somewhere. It's going to be pressured to go up above, creates a ducky look. That ill-defined border, and how do you know that certain fillers cause it? I'll tell you how. If you go to a conference and it's a company that has a filler that draws a lot of water in, and the people from that company obviously can have access to that filler, look at the lip borders of all the people. They're ill-defined, they don't look good, especially as years go by. So the longer someone works for a specific company that might have a filler that does that, the longer the increased chance that they are distorted at their lip border because they're using that product. And it's the same in practices. Some practices only have certain fillers, or they don't want to bring a lot of skews in, so that's how their patients are. And that's why you're going to hear a lot of the controversy. People say, I have a business of dissolving product. That's what I do for a living. I dissolve product. Okay. And all this is a bit of craziness. If people have a great practice and they treat people's faces, the lip is meant to balance the face. I dissolve my own filler that I put in years ago for patients because it migrates, or I just don't like the look. Even if the patient loves their lips, I might say, think about this, I see this or I see that, and I'm not telling them what to do, but it has to look good to my eye, or I'll bring it up to them and see. If they like it, it's great, but I want them to understand what I believe is a good aesthetic look, and I'm sure many of you, your practitioner would do the same. So those are the top four. Now let's go to number five. Some people have said it's just bad luck. I don't buy that one, but some people will say it, and I think what they mean by that is people, what we call double doctor, or go to multiple clinics. So they might not just go to one like was in the day, but they have so many choices now. There's one of these on every corner, and so we don't know what's in people's faces if you don't have a practice that has loyalty, or where you have the trust maybe of the provider. And so we put it off to bad luck. It's just kind of happened. Let someone else take care of it, or I'll dissolve it, save the day. But I don't buy that. I think the aforementioned issues are certainly much more common. The last thing I wanted to bring up is there a new standard? What I mean by that is, are we used to looking at people with bigger lips? Now, I did a poll in my community area on YouTube here, and I asked people, should providers simply fill the lip? I mean, it's easy to do. Someone comes in, just fill it, they're in and out. Filling a lip takes 10 minutes. It's an extra $600 for that day. And there's no one's fighting. You get it done, you send them out. Or should the provider stop and say, hey, I don't think it'll look good, don't do it. 85% of people, and there's 1,500 people as of today that took the poll, 85% of people said it should only be done if the provider believes that it's appropriate. Okay, I don't believe that the aesthetically minded patients believe that, because if you ever are in a position where you're a provider and you provide these services, patients get very upset. They've driven to your office, they want to pick me up, they want to boost, and they have Instagram accounts of people who are injectors, and it's all entirely lips. So what we're used to seeing, if you follow Instagram, less so Facebook, a bit of Snapchat, if you follow that, you're seeing lips that are, should we use the word distorted? Should we use unnatural, or is it the new norm? Hockey rinks are opening back up. I'm thinking, okay, I need a new hockey stick. I'm thinking about it. I open up my computer, there's hockey stick sales. I didn't even search it. Our computers, our phones, they know exactly what we're thinking and what we're looking for. And if that's what we're seeing, if the algorithm send, if you're searching lip fillers, the algorithm send you lip fillers, it's not probably the natural, normal, undistorted lip that was seen 20 years ago, 30 or 40 years ago. Is there a new natural? And this is a big controversial topic, because if it is, are we as providers creating that? People make their living off of lips. So this becomes the question, aside from the whole issue of whose technique it is and which techniques cause it. Are we creating this? Who is responsible? I get this all the time in the comment section, and they come down on the providers, someone like me, or you're creating this monsters in the aesthetic world, creating people and their expected outcomes. But if you look, I would take people first and foremost to Instagram, Facebook, social media. That's what people are seeing, and that's where they're making money. Because understand, it's someone's livelihood you're paying with. If you go to a Vegas show, you get in the back row seats, you're seeing people from 100 yards away, tons of makeup, big lips, big eyes, it's all done up. If you go to Instagram and people make money as an influencer, they look at who they are. If you look a certain way, you're not making that much money. If you look a different way, you're going to make money. And this has been since the test of time. It's been since time started. People with stronger jawlines are more successful, more likely to be CEOs. It's a whole path we can talk about. I want to know from you, are we distorting people? Is there a new level of distortion? And for those who have kids, look at your kids who are coming up from the age of 12, 13. What are they seeing on social media? And what do we do about it? So that's the controversy this month. I wanted to bring it up. What do I think? At the end of the day, I like to create balanced, harmonious faces. When I look at a face, I'm looking at, because it's what I do, the whole face. So I want to treat the forehead, the brows, get hair growth. I want to treat the under eye with plasma. I will use biostimulators to lift and thicken the dermis. I want to treat the whole face, the lower face, the neck, the jawline. And then I'm going to say, do the lips balance this face, and what can we do to add them? If you're a professional, you want to dive into how, where, the anatomy, I do that on my AMIT, the Aesthetic Monthly Insider Training. Go to aesthetictrainingcenter.com. Stay tuned here. Keep your skin and body beautiful, healthy, and vibrant.